Hello and greetings from Iceland. This update is all about the Bárðarbunga earthquake yesterday. And first I would like to say that this is a part of a larger program, first and foremost. So there is no need to make this into some drama. And this video will be the simple version since I have other videos online that dive deeper into this or the Bárðarbunga program. So I'm linking to some of them. But this story is however worthwhile. Bárðarbunga is sometimes called the mother of all Icelandic volcanoes. It's believed to be situated directly above the mantle plume or the hotspot under Iceland. And this is not just about this giant caldera. The volcanic system is about 190 kilometers long and 25 kilometers wide. And after the last eruption in 2014, experts told us that we were only witnessing the beginning of an active period. And the Bárðarbunga magma chamber would start to reload right after the eruption, so we could be expecting frequent earthquakes for the years to come. And the experts got it right, so yesterday's earthquake was no surprise. And I hardly mention earthquakes there unless they have been affecting other systems. It looks like they are doing that sometimes. Or as I was asking in a video just a few days ago, why do we often get strong earthquakes on the Reykjanes Peninsula after strong earthquakes in Bárðarbunga? And yesterday's earthquake in Bárðarbunga was no exception, since a magnitude 3 struck offshore by Reykjanes this morning, followed with some aftershocks and general unrest on the peninsula. And again, I am not the expert. I'm just telling you about the things I notice. And since we got this unusually large earthquake this time, I will be diving a bit deeper today into history, starting with this short time lapse where we see how seismic activity decreases after the 2014 event until we are down to less than 300 earthquakes annually in 2022, but up to 430 in 2023, and 330 earthquakes have been detected so far in 2024, and it's only April. Or over 50% increase from last year. This could of course just be a little spike, but my unscientific gut feeling is saying no this time. So I also made this time lapse where I see all earthquakes accumulate since March 1st, and I included the next door volcano Grímsvötn. It's noticeable that those two giant volcanic systems seem to behave as one, and I did this version because the Grímsvötn volcano could erupt anytime now, and this was our most active volcano until the Reykjanes Peninsula woke up. And as we know from history, Bárðarbunga can easily trigger an eruption in Grímsvötn, and that's just fine because they are quite harmless actually while they are frequent. So my first thought yesterday was to be on the lookout for increased seismic activity in Grímsvötn, but so far everything is cool there, and Mother Earth might have even bigger plans around there. So now I want to mention an interview with Professor Þorvaldur Þórðarson a while ago, where he talks about the extensive land uplift around Vatnajokull glacier, a big part of our island is lifting up. And the easy explanation is of course the fact that Icelandic glaciers have retreated, and the land uplift without inflation from magma accumulation can be quite normal. But there are however no such changes around the other large glaciers, even though they have retreated just as much. So the professor has been saying for some time now that the mantle plume might be teasing us with some kind of increased activity, and this increased activity will increase the frequency of volcanic eruptions. And the 7 eruptions since 2021, they might also be trying to tell us something. So to give you an idea about the forces there, the professor points out that the mantle plume, that in the case of Iceland has created land that reaches 4,000 meters above the seabed. But I have also read articles where this hypothesis about the mantle plume is called into question. I somehow have the feeling though that Bárðarbunga itself is not due for anything big soon. Only a few aftershocks were detected, so like often before, this was just a little burp, and it's over now. But this got me curious of course, so I made a third time lapse. It starts on January 1st and covers a larger area, so it can be a bit confusing to try to focus on the complete picture, and overall this is just a fun format to work with, and it shows us extremely well how lively things are here around the plate boundaries. And finally, I will be on the road tomorrow. I had this trip to the Reykjanes Peninsula planned for some time now, but I also wanted some good weather conditions, and the spring is coming. Icelanders can now be found in their gardens, doing the annual stuff, hammering down the flowers into the frozen ground, but as for me, I look forward to come back with some new footage soon. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.